Welcome to the first week of human anatomy. And this first content video is going to differ a little bit from the subsequent ones that you'll watch because I'm going to give you a little bit more overview of and guidance for kind of how to use these lab content videos and how to move through the lab content in general. So, I have on the screen here the lab manual page open on one side of the screen and the exam images open on the other side of the screen. And the first bit of the week one lab content is anatomical terminology. It's how we speak the language of anatomy. And some of these terms are going to be words that you might use in everyday language. And sometimes in everyday language, we use them a little bit incorrectly, which is totally fine. But that might mean that you need to relearn the proper application more than anything of some of the terms that we are going to have. And so the content for lab is based on the lab manual, and it's very important as you use all the resources that are available to you from the course, as well as out there on the internet and textbooks and all of the resources that you have access to, that you always come back to the lab manual as your guide for what terms to focus on and how the context of our anatomy course is presented. And so in the first part of this anatomical terminology, there is a section of terms that are referred to as body positions and directional terms. And anatomical position is the position of the human body when we write about it in a patient's chart, when we talk about it with another person, if we assume anatomical position, then we can all picture and be on the same page with each other about how the body is positioned. And sort of half of this image here in the middle of the screen is showing you anatomical position, just the left side of the body. Anatomical position is when a human being is standing upright, facing forward, facing anteriorly, with your head straight forward and your arms down at your sides, with the palms also facing anteriorly. So only on this side is the arm positioned in something close to anatomical position. On the other side here, the arm is rotated and the forearm is rotated to put the hand on the hip, so to speak. So this is not anatomical position, while this side is. And this anatomical position is most important in terms of allowing for communication to be somewhat universal when talking about the position of something on the human body. And so we'll refer to anatomical position quite a bit throughout the semester. The rest of the terms that are listed in this section of the anatomical terminology are listed in pairs of opposite terms. Supine and prone can refer to the position of the entire body, or they can refer to the position of the forearm only. And supine means face up, lying down face up, so more. And then prone is lying down face down. And so in our exam images, if I scroll a little bit down, we've got some pictures of a baby doll that is positioned prone, so face down, and then supine, face up. Okay, and then we can also talk about the position of the forearm being supine, meaning the palm is face up, or prone, meaning that the palm is face down. So that's how you'll hear those terms. Superior and inferior mean very similar to how you use those terms outside of anatomical context. Superior means it's higher up than, inferior means lower than. But on the human body in anatomical positions, superior and inferior, should only be used on the head and the torso. We're going to have different terms to use on the appendages. And then cranial and caudal are analogous to superior and inferior. Cranial means that something is closer to the head, so higher up than. And then caudal, it means tail, so it means closer to the tail. So again, limited to the head and the torso, cranial and caudal are analogous to superior and inferior, respectively. Superior and inferior tend to be used more commonly, but you can switch out those terms appropriately. Anterior and posterior. Anterior means closer to the front. Posterior means closer to the back. And then ventral and dorsal are again analogous to those terms as well. So anterior means closer to the front. Ventral means closer to the belly. And so because in anatomical position, the belly is on the anterior of the body, ventral and anterior are then synonymous with each other. And then posterior means closer to the back. Dorsal means back as in like the spine. And so that also means closer to the back. So you can use either posterior or dorsal kind of interchangeably. And ventral and dorsal are going to be commonly used terms with respect to the nervous system. So those will definitely come up again later in the semester. Medial and lateral. Medial means closer to the midline, and lateral means further out to the side. So if we think about this arm in anatomical position, if the hand, the palm of the hand is facing anteriorly, then the thumb is lateral to the pinky. And I know you can't see my arm alongside my body, but the pinky is closer to the midline of the body in anatomical position than the thumb. The thumb is more lateral in anatomical position. Proximal and distal are the terms that are used only on the appendages. So only on the upper limb and the lower limb in terms of the way that we'll use them in this class, although there are a few more applications that get used. Proximal is defined as being closer to the point of attachment. So on the upper limb, it attaches at the shoulder via the pectoral girdle, the scapula, and the clavicle. But essentially, it means closer to the shoulder. And then distal, like distant, means farther away. And then superficial and deep. Superficial means closer to the surface, while deep means just what it sounds like, deeper inside, underneath, so to speak. And so all of these terms, without regard to anatomical position, the rest of these terms are used as relative directional terms to compare the position of one thing to the position of another. So early in the semester, when we haven't really talked about any other anatomy yet, you could say that the elbow is proximal to the wrist. The ankle is distal to the knee. You could say that the lungs, which are here on either side of the heart, are superior to the liver, which is here just below the diaphragm. And so you're not just saying this is distal. It's distal compared with what, right? And in terms of application on a patient's chart, for example, you might talk about the position of a laceration or a tumor or a mole in dermatology, right? So you might be describing the position of something that isn't necessarily expected to be on every human body in relation to landmarks of the body. And so very important to practice with these relational terms and remember that they are used to relate the position of one thing to another. So I mentioned the elbow being proximal to the wrist, but I could also say that the elbow is distal to the shoulder, right? So it depends on what I'm relating the elbow to. All right.